And joining us now live this morning to talk to us about how to determine what age is right for you when retiring is financial advisor Mark Collin. It's always good to see you.
Hey, thanks there,
for
good
being
morning,
back.
Tanya.
Good morning. Okay, so how does a person even decide to determine when they should retire?
I love talking about this because this is what I talk about a lot with my clients, is really having that discussion and trying to start figuring that out, because you just kind of start and go, I really don't know where to start.
Yeah, every person's different.
And the first thing is that don't let cultural norms and what you see other people doing dictate what you're doing, because it may not be right for you. There's a lot of different ways to think about. And I kind of wanted to go through today kind of the different ways that we can do that, from an early retirement to a more kind of a full retirement age according to Social Security, and then even delaying it a little bit, and kind of what the pros and cons are with those.
Right. Okay. So what are some of those?
Well, basically, if you're going to retire early, you need to make sure you got the nest egg there,
right?
Because you are spending a lot more money over
exactly.
a lot more years. You've got to look at things like inflation. You've got to look at things like, you can actually, over a 20-year period, if you figure in a 3% inflation rate, you actually almost cut your purchasing power in half over that 20 years, because the cost of stuff goes up over
time.
So
you have to figure in a 3% is a good general rule.
2 to 3%, exactly, yes.
Okay. So how do people start preparing specifically for retirement?
Well, what I like to talk to folks about is the fact that I don't want you retiring just from something. I want you retiring to something. You need to have a purpose. You need
Absolutely.
To have some meaning, because there's an important number, 168. There's 168 hours in a week.
Right.
If you're working, most likely you're spending about 2/3 of every week working and sleeping.
That's sad.
Well, that's just that. That's just the truth.
But that's the truth.
But after you decide, I'm not going to go to get up and go to work anymore, that's a lot of time to fill. You better make sure that you've got things to do during that time.
A lot of people don't know what to do with themselves.
I've seen some research that says basically 27% of people who retire actually go back to work within the next 6 months. I read a story about a man who liked to fix things. Thought he was going to spend a lot of time in the garage. He retired, fixed a lot of things that needed fixing, and then after a few months, nothing else needed fixing. He was actually looking to things to break to start fixing again.
He needs some stuff to, he needs to come to my house.
Yes, he can call
Tanya
and come out and help out a little bit. But think about the things that, and I know, for instance, with your job, I know that the hours probably aren't exactly what you like, getting up very early in the morning sometimes.
I'm trying to get used to it, but at this point,
But think about the things you really do like about your job.
Right.
You've got folks, and I see it when I come in, you've got camaraderie, you've got friends here, there's social interaction, there's achievement, you're useful, things, people are using you and your knowledge to do things, and you know, a lot of people get a lot of things out of work.
That's
and
true.
So you've got to make sure that you've got that attention and that purpose and meaning somewhere else if you're not going to come to work every day.
Yeah, sure. Well, you come in early, you get off early, so that's one benefit of my job.
Yeah.
Okay, so what if, say, somebody's like, you know, in their 60s and they really do and are thriving and enjoying their career and job, and they don't want to retire? I mean, you can just continue.
You know what? Then don't.
Yeah,
it helps,
don't retire.
It helps in a lot of different ways. If you're retiring early, you got to look at things like, hey, where's my health insurance going to come from before 65 in Medicare? Am I cutting my pension or my Social Security at a rate that I can't make that up over the years? If you're delaying that retirement, and I've got a lot more folks who are doing more of a phased out retirement, where you do work more of a part-time schedule or a flexible schedule, you might be surprised when you ask your boss and talk to your folks. They really want people who know the job and who are good, who they can depend on to stick around, even if it's in a 20-hour or 30-hour a week status. So feel free to ask your folks. I've got a lot of folks who are working 15, 20 hours a week. They're adding a little change to their pocket. They're not spending as much of their nest egg, so that's going to last even longer. And it's just a better situation all the way around, because they're still being fulfilled. They're still doing something that really fulfills them and has purpose.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but what is the age? Is it 62 when you can start drawing
you
or
can
getting
start
your
Social Security at 62. Okay. For full retirement age, it's going to be somewhere between 66 and 67, depending on your age. And again, what folks don't realize, if you're still working, that Social Security will actually grow up until age 70. Every year, you're guaranteed that between 67 and 70, it's going to grow about 8% a year.
Okay.
And you're locking in a larger number
that
then you'll be drawing until you're 80, 85, 90.
Yeah.
And maybe on.
Yeah.
One thing
I did not know that.
One thing to realize, 70. Though, for most people, if there's not a history of illness or there's things happening with you from a health perspective in your life, add a few years to how long you think you're going to live. That's one of the things that can ruin a financial plan, and one of the things that can ruin things if you're retiring too early. People don't think they're going to live as long as they really do.
Right.
That's a huge deal. That and long-term care are two of the things that can really mess up a financial plan. just add a few years to it. We actually plan, unless you tell me differently, we plan until about age 95 because I've got to make sure you have money.
Yeah.
If you live that at age,
people
I don't need you coming back to
longer.
Me. I don't need you coming back to 85 going, hey,
right.
I'm still here, but my money's gone.
Right. Yeah.
That's not a good planner.
Yeah.
I need to plan and make sure you've got that on down the road.
All right. Well, thank you so much. We're out of time, but I appreciate you being here with us.
No problem.
And if you'd like to get in touch with Mark, we will make sure to put his contact information on our website at JothamFirst.com. We'll be right back.